Hello, welcome. In today's class, we use the ultrasonic sensor to create a smart light switch. We have houses where immediately you walk into the house, the lights come on. When you leave, the lights go off. Similar cases are you get into some high-class restaurants and the doors open by themselves or the gates open by themselves. These practical cases can be built using this same method we want to use in this class. So the components we will need for this project are, number one, we need the ultrasonic sensor. We use the HCSR04. Number two, we have our Arduino Uno. Number three, we have our LED. Then number four, you also need the breadboard. We will need a 220 ohm resistor, and we also need some jumper wires. Remember we said that on this horizontal line, the points here, they are all connected. Then on this part, points they are connected together vertically. That being said, the first thing I want to do now is I want to set up the ground. I want all my negatives to enter this particular line on the breadboard. So I click here and then I go to my Arduino and I select the ground. We have this pin as ground and also have this pin as ground. So I connect to this one, I've set up my ground. I bring my ultrasonic sensor. The ultrasonic sensor has four pins. We have the ground, we have the echo, we have the trigger, and we have the VCC. The VCC is same thing like the 5 volts. We connect it to the 5 volts in the Arduino, and we connect the ground to ground. So I connect my ground, and I connect it to the ground on this same line. Connect it here. You can pick any other place. Then I connect my 5 volts. This is the 5 volts. And I connect it to 5 volts on my Arduino. So this is the 5 volt on the Arduino next to the ground. So I connect it there. And the next thing is I want to use the green pin for trig. And I connect this green pin to my Arduino. I want to connect it to pin 13. This 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, pin 13. And then I connect my echo pin to pin 12 on my Arduino. 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So the next thing is to connect our LED. For our LED, the short leg is the negative and the long leg is the positive. So the short leg is more like the ground. Then we'll connect the long leg to any of the digital pins. So we'll use pin 11 in this case. Remember, this line represents my ground. I come any of these points and I fix the negative to the ground. This is the short leg. I fix it to the ground and I fix the long leg across. I take a resistor. I fix on the same line. We have a full tutorial on resistors connecting LEDs, so you can watch that to follow up on this. The positive leg of the LED is on the same line with the resistor. Then I connect the wire from this other leg of the resistor and I take it to pin 11 on my Arduino. 8, 9, 10, 11. So that's the simple connection. Next thing, connect your Arduino to your laptop. I have my Arduino connected to my laptop. I want us to save this as project number 2 and we call it a smart light project. So the first thing is to declare our variables. We want to create variables and assign pins to them. We want to create a variable called trig pin, and our trig pin in the board we use pin 13. We want to create another variable called echo pin. In the board we used 12, and we want to create another variable called LED, and for the LED we use pin 11. Then we create the variable that will measure the time it takes for the echo pin to receive the signal, and we want to call that variable duration. It will help us measure the time. Then we also want to create another variable that will measure the distance between the object and the sensor, and that variable, we want to call that variable distance. Create another variable that will hold the safe distance. So we want to call that variable limit. Let's call it limit. And then we'll give it an initial value of 5 cm. The limit in this case serves as a boundary point. If the object comes to a point less than the limit we have set here, which is 5 cm, the light comes on. If it's higher, the lights remain off. In void setup, first thing we'll do is to set the pin modes. And the first thing we want to do is to pin mode for the trig pin, set it as an output pin. Pin mode for the echo pin, set it as an input pin. Pin mode for the LED, set it as an output pin. Then we start the serial monitor. So we use serial.begin and we keep it at the baud rate of 9600. Now we get into the code section. So say digital write trig pin low and the delay in microseconds. Keep it for 2 microseconds. Then we'll send the sound wave, trig pin set it at high, and delay microseconds, 10 microseconds, and trip in low. So you have sent the sound wave, then check the time it takes to receive the returned wave. And we say the variable we want to use to hold this is called duration, and we use the pulse in from the echo pin when it is high. Then we use this to calculate the distance. Remember we said that the distance is equal to 0.017 multiplied by duration. So we say our distance is equal to 0.017 multiplied by the duration. Now we created a variable called limit and we set that value to 5. So we want to check if the distance is less than 5 or is greater than 5. So we use an if statement. If the distance is less than or equal to 5, the light will come on. If the distance is higher than 5, the light will be off. If distance is less than or equal to limit, then turn on the LED. Digital right LED, set it to high. Else, digital right LED low. Let's turn it off. We did not write the comments here, so the comment is check if the limit has been exceeded. So finally, we will print this output on a serial monitor. Print the distance on a serial monitor. So say serial.print, want to say the distance in centimeter is in serial.print in a new line, print the distance, then add a delay of 1 second. Let's upload the code to Arduino and see how this works. First, I click here to verify the code. Done compiling, no error. Remember to select your port. I click it and my port is selected. And I say OK and I upload the code. Immediately gets to 5 centimeter. The light comes on. If you take it back, the light goes off. Take it anywhere between 5 centimeter and less than 5 centimeter. The light comes on. You can use the same principle to turn on and turn off the buzzer, close and open a door, and do other phone projects. It's on 5 centimeter, the distance in centimeter. Remove it, so when the light is off, it's working and it's reading. So automatically we're using the sensor at this point to measure distance, and we're using it to turn on and turn off the LED. Okay, so thank you. I hope you enjoyed the project. Check for the classwork and the assignments, do them. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you very much.